ठीक है, ओके, सो आई गेस वी कैन स्टार्ट. ठीक है, सो एज आई सेड इन दिस सेशन वी आर स्टार्टिंग द न्यू सब्जेक्ट विच इज योर डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, और यू कैन से डीबीएमएस. सो एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट आई एम टीचिंग दिस सब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम अ वेरी लॉन्ग आफ्टर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम. सो आई टॉट दिस सब्जेक्ट लास्ट टाइम इन 2000, आई थिंक 16, 2016 17 आई टॉट दिस सब्जेक्ट. सो आफ्टर 2016 17 आई एम टीचिंग दिस सब्जेक्ट नाउ, आई मीन आफ्टर आई थिंक 2016. सो इट्स लाइक आफ्टर अ गैप ऑफ 4 ईयर्स आई एम टीचिंग दिस सब्जेक्ट. ठीक है, सो आई ट्राई माई बेस्ट दैट आई कैन कवर द बेसिक्स. सो आई ट्राई माई बेस्ट दैट आई कैन कवर दिस इन अ गुड एनफ डेप्थ, एंड लेट अस सी हाउ वी कैन डू इट. ठीक है, सो वी हैव नोफला हियर, रोहित, योगेश, रितु, ग्रेट. सो अगेन गुड इवनिंग टू एवरी वन. हाई मानसा, सो वी गॉट 10 पीपल हियर एंड वी हैव मानसा, नोफला, आई डोंट नो, जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर एवरीवन टू ज्वाइन इन. तो जैसे ही सभी ज्वाइन इन करेंगे हम लोग स्टार्ट कर सकते हैं. ओके, सो आई थिंक वी कैन स्टार्ट. ठीक है, सो अगेन एज आई सेड द नेम ऑफ सब्जेक्ट इज डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, और यू कैन से डीबीएमएस. सो एज यू कैन सी द इमेज हियर, सो दिस इज एन इमेज ऑफ एन एटीएम. So this data management system, it is widely used in a lot of financial applications. Maybe your databases are used in banking system, very widely used in banking system, a lot of places where it is used. So but banking system is one of the very critical example where databases are used very frequently. Okay, so here this database management system, these videos will be helpful for again GATE. So those people who are preparing for GATE, those people who are preparing for UGC NET, those people who are preparing for any of the competitive examinations which is having computer science, so these videos are going to be very helpful for all of them. Even if you are preparing for PGT examinations, then you know this is going to be very helpful. Fine. So here we have, so whenever I'm reading here, so I have two windows here which is open. So this is on the right hand side. So on the right hand side, all of you guys are there, Anjali, Jyoti, Vandana, Mansa, Nofla, Kajol, everyone is here. And on the left hand side, we are live on another channel also. So we are live doing this live on two channels at the same time. Okay, so I want to finish this entire subject live for all of you, and let us see how it goes. Okay, so what are the things that we will be covering here today? Aaj ke topics, aaj hum log kya kya cheeze cover karenge. So first of all, we will be doing this first session, which is about introduction to databases. This first session is about introduction, and then we will start our second session after a break. In your second session, we will be discussing about this ER model, that is entity relationship model, and then in our third session, we are going to discuss about normalization. Third session will be regarding normalization. Okay, so this introduction session, again, this is mostly a theoretical section. So where the basic theories of this database management system I'm covering, I'm not very good with the theories, but again I'll try my best that I can give you a basic brief theories. But again, we are going to have major focus on normalization. Okay, so this is your first session today, this is your second session, and this will be your third session. Okay, so let us first of all go through the syllabus of this entire subject and number of hours that it will take us to cover this entire syllabus. So the first topic here is introduction, that is introduction to database management system. So this topic will take approximately 1 hour, 45 minutes to 1 hour. So basically your first session is approximately 45 minutes to 1 hour. Then your next session will be regarding ER models. I think it is not visible. Let me do something, some changes, because I can make it visible. Yeah. So then next changes, next subject will be your ER model. And this ER model topic will take approximately 1 to 1.5 hour. 1 to 1.5 hour, approximately 1.5 hour, roughly you can say. And then we will be having this relational model. So again, in this relational model, again this is more like an ER model only, but we will discuss about it in more details. Then we are going to have this functional dependencies and normalization. So this topic is your lengthy topic. Functional dependencies and normalization will take approximately 5 to 6 hours to cover. This is a topic of 5 to 6 hours. Then we have relational algebra, and relational calculus. So these are two different topics. Relational algebra is different and relational calculus is different. So this relational algebra topic, ये जो आपका relational algebra topic है, it will again take us 2 to 3 hours to cover. And this relational calculus topic will also take us 2 to 3 hours to cover. Then we have structured query language, or you can say SQL. Again, SQL will take approximately 4 to 5 hours. 4 to 5 hours जो है, वो हमें SQL में लग सकते हैं. So maybe more. I mean, we can spend approximately 6 hours in SQL. लगभग 6 घंटे जो है हम लोग SQL में ही cover कर सकते हैं. We can, as many examples we take, it is always less. Right? Number of examples. जितने भी examples लेंगे सभी हमेशा कम है. So we can spend any number of topics here. Then we have transaction management and concurrency control. So this transaction management and concurrency control, it is approximately 4 to 5 hours again. Again, ये 4 से 5 घंटे का रहेगा. And then we have this file organization and indexing. So this topic, which is file organization and indexing, it is approximately of, I should say, it will take us 3 to 4 hours. It will take us 3 to 4 hours to cover this topic. Okay. Now, apart of this, there are some topics regarding advanced database management system. So when I'm saying advanced DBMS, maybe I can cover NoSQL in advanced DBMS. So those topics will be extra. जो advanced DBMS के concepts हैं, advanced DBMS के जो topics हैं, वो सभी extra हैं. और ये जो सभी topics हैं, they are the basic core concepts of database management system. So I'm going to consider them as two different subjects. One is your core database management system, and then your advanced database management system, where I'm also going to cover this NoSQL. ठीक है? Yes, that is a different subject. Data mining is a different subject, and data warehousing is a different subject. So in UGCNet, they have given this everything in one database unit. But data mining is a subject, data warehousing is a subject. These are two different subjects, and majorly most of the concept they ask from data mining and data warehousing is majorly theoretical questions. But still sometimes they can ask numerical. So we are going to consider them as different subjects. We are going to keep those subjects separate as compared to DBMS. हम सभी subject को DBMS से separate रखेंगे. Now how many questions they asked from database management system? So if you remember it from the beginning of the class, I told you, okay, let me also open it on my end, because some of you are asking how many questions they asked from database management system. I don't really remember it, but let me also ask for UGCNet, because just hold on a second. So I know the latest statistics. So in database management system, they asked 8 questions. Database management system say, jo abhi recent aapka UGCNet ka exam hua tha. In UGCNet exam, they have asked 8 questions, which is a very good number. 8 is a very good number. But when you check out other subjects like data mining, they've asked only 1 question from data mining, and from data warehousing, no question was there. So you can consider this as the major most important subject. Data mining and data warehousing, it is not the case that every time they're asking questions from data mining and data warehousing. Even if they're asking the questions, then they're asking hardly 1 or 2 questions. So as I said, data mining and data warehousing, you can leave. But again, I will try my best if I can cover it. Agar main so cover kar sakta hun, definitely I will cover in the class. And then data mining and data warehousing, we are going to do in the last. Okay? Yes, so majorly here we are going to study SQL, because core concepts are there. So hum log yahan par sabse pehle core concepts ko study karenge, and then separately I will show you the same applications in Oracle. So jo uski applications hai, how to apply the same SQL statements in Oracle, I will show that separately. Theek hai? Any other question before we start? So the number of questions they ask from data warehousing, the number of questions they ask from data mining and advanced DBMS, it is very low. So from these three subjects, they hardly ask 1 question. वो सिर्फ एक ही question पूछते हैं. So that is why I'm saying you should majorly focus on these topics, because just from these topics you will get approximately 7 to 8 questions in UGCNet. Out of 100, 7 to 8 questions will be only from these topics. Rest of the topics which are regarding the advanced database management system or regarding the advanced topics, they hardly ask any question from that portion. ठीक है? Fine. So let us start, I guess. So first of all, a few terminologies that you should know. When I say data, what do I really mean by data? Data means the raw facts and figure. For example, I can say that you have the data regarding the temperature of a country, or you have a data regarding, if let us suppose we are living in Delhi, I'm in Delhi. So if you have some data regarding what is the temperature of Delhi every single day, or temperature of Delhi every single hour. So that is just a data. But how can you find information? To find some kind of information, you have to process the data. Let us suppose I want to get a data regarding what will be the changes in the temperature. Temperature mein kya changes aayenge in the upcoming, you know, 1 month. So that means I can predict those changes according to the past experiences that we have. So to get some kind of information, we have to process the data. So data and information, these are two different concepts. Do not ever consider the data and information as same concept, because they are two different concepts. Data always means raw facts and figure, and information always means the processed data. Okay. Next is records. So it is logically related data is called as a record. Jo data logically related hai, hum usko records bolte hain. And when I say database, so database is a collection of similar records, or you can say it is a very large integrated collection of data. So jo aapke paas bahut zyada bada data hai, bahut zyada large data hai, usko hum mostly database bolte hain. But again, database means it is the collection of many records, or large number of records is called as a database. And then we have database management system. So database management system is kind of a software, kind of an application which works on the database. So I can show you in this manner. So basically you have a database. So we represent database in this case. Now is figure say we represent a database. We represent a database like this. So what is this database? Database is just the collection of records. That's it. But then with this database, we also add some softwares. We also add some software, or can say some applications. We also add some application. And what is the use of these applications? These applications are going to make it easier for us to work on this database. Maybe I want to add some data. Maybe I want to delete some data. Maybe I want to create some new tables. Maybe I want to extract some information. I want to get average of something. Let us suppose I want to say what is the average temperature of Delhi between the month of March to April. So I'm performing some kind of operations on the data. So basically this database itself is not working. I mean, you have to perform, you have to write various programs to get information from the database, but rather than, instead of writing the program separately, what we use a database management system. And this database management system is the collection of these programs, or you can say collection of these applications with the database itself. And these applications makes it easier for us to work on the database. Okay? Clear? Now here, for the database, again, for DBMS, some of you are asking me, what is a book that you can refer? DBMS. So there are two major books we have that we refer. One is Nawathe. Pehli jo book hogi wo Nawathe hogi, that you can refer. And second book is Korth. You can refer any of these books. So what I personally feel is Nawathe is a standard book, which is the best book for database management system. But the problem is in Nawathe, the language is not very easy. Nawathe ki jo language hai, wo itni asaan nahi hai. But the language given in Korth is much easier to understand. But I feel is Nawathe, the topics are given to the point. They are not having a lot of extra information, because in Korth, a lot of extra information is also there. But understanding the Korth is much easier as compared to Nawathe. So if you can understand Nawathe, then you should follow it. Otherwise, you can follow Korth. So these are the two books that you can refer for DBMS. Otherwise, first make sure whatever I'm teaching here, try to follow my notes, try to follow my presentations and PPTs. There is going to be more than enough. Then if you feel that you have time, because for June 2020, you will not be having enough time to read the books. Correct? So first should be my lectures. First follow my lectures. First follow the PPTs and the lectures that I give. And then if you have some time, if you have a lot of extra time, then you can follow the books. Okay? Fine. So what are the application of database? As you can see, there are a lot of applications of database. One is your so one is the applications regarding in the banking system. So in banking system, a lot of transactions are happening day by day. A lot of people are depositing some money, a lot of people are taking some money out, they are working on loans, and a lot of things are there. So for all the day-to-day transaction, to keep the record of the day-to-day transactions in the banking system, we use a centralized database. Hum yahan par ek centralized database ka use karte hain. After this, we have airline reservation schedules, right? So in airline reservations, here to keep track of all the airlines, how many seats are already booked. Maybe let us suppose you want to go from Delhi to Bombay. So if you want to go from Delhi to Bombay from Air India airline, now in this Air India airline, how many seats are already booked and how many seats are already left? So in those cases also, in airlines, we keep database regarding the airlines. Lot of information we store. It might be related to the number of seats which are available. It might be related to the timing of the airlines, at what time they are operating, what is the average delay they are getting in terms of servicing. So a lot of these information is stored regarding airlines. So in airline system, reservation system, we also use databases. Then after this, we have universities. So in a university, at least 1000 to 2000 students study. So to maintain the information regarding all these 2000 students is very difficult. To maintain all of these information, we use databases. So which can be related to the database of the names of all the students, their addresses, their contact numbers, their courses, their enrolled courses, what are the marks they are getting, what is the average marks they are getting. There are a lot of information regarding the students. So in universities and colleges also, we use database management system. After this, we have sales. Maybe if you are going to a shopping mall, if you are going to a shop, so what is the customers, what are the customers that they are coming, so what are the products which are available, what is the prices of the product, so what is the average profit you can calculate using this, right? So a lot of information in the sales database we store here. Then in the manufacturing industry also, we use databases to manage the inventory, that how many products are remaining, how many products are still available, how many products, what is the demand of the product, kitne products ki demand hai, kitne products available hai. So to maintain this order supply chain also, we use databases in the manufacturing industry. Usi tarike se even in the HR, human resource department in a company, maybe let us suppose it is a Infosys, or it is a Wipro, or it is a Satyam, right? Any kind of company. So now Satyam is not there, but so in all of these companies, they maintain records regarding the employees. What are the dependent, who are the dependents of the employee, what are the contact information, their salaries, how much salary is credited, is a salary which is remaining, all of these information. So what are the tax reductions? So in HR, HRs also maintain databases in the company. So basically you can see the databases are used everywhere in our day-to-day life. You cannot even imagine you are having. So data is basically the most, it is the most precious resource nowadays. So if somebody asks you what is the most precious resource, oil is not the most precious resource. Oil is not the most expensive resource, right? Even your gold is not the most expensive resource. Diamond is not the most expensive resource, but rather information is the most expensive resource nowadays. If you have data, if you have information, then you can find out a lot of new information, and you can use this lot of new information in many places. Maybe let us suppose you are doing stock trading. So if you have the data regarding what is the past experiences, the past trend of a stock, if you have a database regarding the past trends of a stock, then with those trends, you will be able to predict the future trends of the stock. You will be able to predict whether the stock will go up or whether the stock will go down. So if you have heard of the strategy of algorithmic trading, so in algorithmic trading, again, they use these databases, and to predict the trends also, they use this historical data. So maintain this historical data also, we have databases. Okay, so you can clearly see that databases are very, very important for us. For most of the websites, everything nowadays is based on database. So it is very important for us to study these databases. Okay. सो वट इफ वी डो नॉट हैव डेटाबेस, अगर हमारे पास डेटाबेस नहीं होता तो क्या होता? वट इफ वी डोंट हैव अ डेटाबेस, लेट अस अज्यूम दैट यू आर हैविंग अ कंपनी, राइट? सो ऑल द गाइज हियर हु आर प्रेजेंट एंड माई बेस्ट फ्रेंड हियर शुभम, राइट? सो शुभम इज हैविंग अ डेटाबेस. सो शुभम, लेट अस सपोज शुभम इज हैविंग अ डेटाबेस एंड ही इज हैविंग अ वेरी लार्ज कंपनी and in this company he is having information of all the employees which are working in the company, and in all of these employees, so the data that they have regarding all of these employees is approximately 500 gigabytes. It is approximately 500 gigabytes. And what are the information that we are storing here? So yahan par kya kya information hum log store kar rahe hain? So we are storing the information regarding the employees, the departments, the products, the sales, and so a lot of information regarding this company. And there are many people, many employees who are concurrently working on this database. So this is the database, this is the database, and this database is approximately 500 gigabytes, and a lot of employees. So this is a department, maybe this is your HR department, they are working on this database. This is your finance department, this finance department is working on this database. Maybe you have a department for sales, so this sales department is also working on this database. Okay, you have inventory department, a lot of products department, so all of these departments are working on the same database. Now the problem is, if it do not have this database management system, this is just representing a database, it is not representing a database management system, it is only representing a database. Now if we do not have the database management system, to kya hoga? We have to use the file system, जो आपके ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में ऑलरेडी अवेलेबल है. सो वी हैव टू यूज ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम फाइल सिस्टम, राइट? जैसे यू हैव टेक्स्ट फॉर्मेट, नोट्स फॉर्मेट, सो दैट इज वी यूज डॉट टी एक्स टी एज अ फॉर्मेट, और मे वी कैन यूज द वर्ड फाइल एज अ फॉर्मेट, वी कैन यूज एक्सेल शीट. सो एक्सेल इट सेल्फ इज अ डेटाबेस, जो एक्सेल है, आप जो एम एस ऑफिस में एक्सेल यूज करते हैं, दैट इज ऑल्सो रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ डेटाबेस. If you do not have any other file system, but rather if you are storing every data in the text format, then performing operations on this huge database will be very complicated. Bahut zyada complicated hoga is pe operations ko perform karna. Let me tell you how. Now listen to this very carefully, maybe you will understand. What happens is, whenever your CPU want to perform any operation on any data element, first of all, the CPU have to bring this entire database or this entire data in the main memory. But again, bringing all of these 500 GBs of database in the main memory is extremely difficult. Ye bahut zyada difficult hone wala hai, because you are going to need a huge main memory in that case. What will happen? First of all, you will not be able to bring the entire database. And let us suppose that you found out a way that I can only bring a small chunk of this database in the main memory. Then you have to write programs to find out the data from this. Let us suppose you want to find out the list of all the employees whose age is less than 26. I want to find out the list of all the employees whose age is greater than 22 and less than 26. So for getting just this simple data, I have to write a set of programs. I have to execute those set of programs to perform these operations, which is going to be very, very complicated. Correct. So what are the problems that we are going to face here? So the first problem here is to access the data. To access all of this data, we have to bring all this entire 500 GB of data in the main memory, which is going to be very, very difficult. Jo ki bahut difficult hone wala hai. Secondly, let us assume that your main memory, your operating system, your computer system is a 32-bit addressing system. It is a 32-bit system. So I think all of you know that we can have two kinds of system. We can have a 32-bit system. We can also have a 64-bit system. So nowadays, every system that we are having is 64-bit. What do you mean by 64-bit? 64 means we have 64 address lines. What do you mean by 32-bits? We have 32 address lines. So in the 32-bit system, the maximum main memory which is supported is only 4 gigabytes. In the 64-bit system, the maximum main memory which is supported is 2^64 gigabytes. So here, if the system is 32-bit, that means the maximum memory that we can have is only 4 gigabytes, 4 GB. So the maximum data that we can bring from the secondary memory to the main memory is only 4 GBs. First of all, you have to design a set of programs so that you can do something like this. So this is your 500 GB of database. So you have to design a set of programs which can bring 4 GB of this data here, work on these 4 GB of data, then again put it back and again bring the 4 GB of data, work on this, put it back, again bring the 4 GB of data, work on this, put it back, again bring the 4 GB of data, work on this, put it back, and so on. करेक्ट. तो आपका जो डेटा है उसमें आपको थोड़ा थोड़ा डेटा को मेमोरी मेन मेमोरी पर लेकर आना पड़ेगा और फिर उस डेटा पर आपको काम करना पड़ेगा, विच इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी टीडियस टास्क, वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क. एंड इमेजिन यू वॉन्ट टू परफॉर्म सम ऑपरेशन विच इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू अपडेट दिस 4 GB डेटा दैट यू आर ब्रिंगिंग एंड दिस अपडेट्स आर ऑल्सो यूज विद अदर डेटा. Then this operation is going to be extremely difficult because this operation is going to be very recursive. ये recursively ही call करेगा, recursively अपने आप को execute करेगा. Okay, what I mean to say here is that this is your 500 GB of database. ये आपका 500 GB of database है, right? And this is your main memory which is of 4 gigabytes. So you can only bring 4 GB of this data here. And let us assume that operation that you are performing here is a changing operation. Maybe you want to update the salaries. So according to some criteria, you are updating the salary. And then after updating the salary, you are going to take it back here. Aap salary ko update karne ke baad isko dobara yahan par lekar jayenge. And this updation is again, because this updation is there. So obviously the data in the entire database will change. Why? Maybe because of average. You want to find out maybe कि आपको डेटा को अपडेट करना है, then you have to find out the average. ठीक है, so क्या होगा कि after performing the changes, again you have to check the same data. Again you have to check after performing the changes. Again you have to check the same data. So basically, kind of some operations can be designed in such a way that those operations are recursive. So then managing this will be extremely difficult. It will be extremely tedious. So this is the first problem that you can face. Okay, what can the second problem? What can be the second problem? So again, to solve these problems, you have to write special programs. And after writing the special program, it will become a very complex or tedious task. Ye aapke liye bahut hi complex or tedious task ho jayega. Okay. Now, then we have to protect the data from inconsistent changes. Aapko data ko inconsistent changes se protect karna hai. And what are these inconsistent changes? Let me explain you this manner. So let us assume, I hope it should be visible. Let me change the size because I don't have enough space here. I have not actually left the space to write here, so I should have left this space. So let us assume that we have two people here. The first person is Shubham, and Shubham is working in HR department. And the second person is maybe Madhu. So these are two people, Shubham and Madhu. And Madhu is also working in maybe HR department. Okay, both of them are working in the HR department. Now, and because we only have one file, we are not using any kind of database. Because we only have one file, which is stored using this operating system file system. So kya hoga? Shubham is also working on this one file, as well as Madhu is also working on this one file. Dono ek hi file ke upar kaam kar rahe hain. Now, Shubham said that certain person, maybe Himanshu, haven't got the salary, but Madhu said he got the salary. Okay. So Shubham, first of all, is going to read the data. Then Madhu will read the data. Then Shubham will perform the operation. Then Madhu will perform the operation. And then Shubham will commit the operation. And then Madhu will commit the operation. So whoever is going to commit the operation later on, jo sabse baad mein isko commit karega, whoever is going to commit later on, its data will be saved. For example, Madhu's data will be saved. So basically, Shubham wanted to show something, Madhu wanted to show something, but again, both of these things conflicted with each other. Okay, I think I've not given a proper example. Let me give you a better example here. Let me try to give you a better example. Okay. Let us suppose this is a bank account. This is the bank account, and in this bank account we have 1,000 rupees. Isme 1,000 rupees hai. So Shubham is also in the HR department, and he is saying that I want to add 1,000 rupees in this bank account. And Madhu is also from the HR department and she wants to remove 1000 rupees or maybe 500 rupees from this account. So, sabse pehle kya hoga? First of all, Shubham will read the account is having 1000 rupees. So, Shubham ke baad jo data store hai, that is 1000. Then Madhu will also read the account is having 1000 rupees. Then Shubham will perform a write operation. That means Shubham will change this 1000 to 2000, but abhi Shubham ne commit nahi kiya. Right? Shubham have not committed this operation. Then Madhu will also perform a write operation. So Madhu will change this 1000 to 500. Then Shubham will perform a commit operation. That means commit operation means Shubham is going to update this data. He is going to say that this account is having 2000 rupees. And after this, Madhu performs this commit operation. So Madhu is going to say that this account is now having 500 rupees. So basically, the account should be having 1500. But now, because of these operations where both of them are working concurrently, where both of them are working parallelly, because of these operations, this data is a basically inconsistent data. Ye correct data nahi hai, it is an inconsistent data. So we can have such kind of problems. Agar hamare paas kuch log parallelly kaam kar rahe hain, the people are working parallelly, then we can get an inconsistent data. Secondly, there are more ways, a lot of different things can happen here. So we'll look at all of these things one by one. So if you read this line, just read this line again. If you read this line, so it is written, we must protect the data from inconsistent changes. Hame data ko inconsistent changes se protect karna hai. Maybe when the people are trying to access the data concurrently. Agar ek se zyada log data ko ek hi saath access karne ki koshish kar rahe hain us case mein. Okay. And then what if you are performing some operations and your system crashes? What if your system crash? If you are performing some operation, maybe you want to insert some data in the database, okay, and your system crashes. So if the system crashes, then if you are using a file system, it will lead to an inconsistent state of the system. If you are using a database, it will always maintain an inconsistent state. And then it is a very important issue, which is the password mechanism for security. You say everyone is not allowed to access the same database. Jaise ki if a person is sitting in the laboratory, he is not allowed to access the finances of another employee. If a person is sitting in finance department, he is not allowed to access the marks of a student. Correct? So basically what happens is that we have to give some kind of access to some departments and we have to restrict some departments to have some kind of access. Hum log sabhi ko har tarah ki access nahi de sakte. We have to maintain what is the kind of access we want to give to a particular person. So here we should have two kind of security here. First of all, any unauthorized person should not be able to access the database. Koi bhi unauthorized person jo hai wo database ko access na kar paye. And secondly, anyone who is not having authorization. So these are two things, right? So for example, what I'm trying to say is, let us suppose I am a normal human being. I am not a bank employee. I'm not allowed to access the database of a bank. So bank mujhe apna database allow nahi kar sakta. But at the same time, because I'm not allowed, they should have some security for this. As well as if an employee who is in the bank, so maybe the employee is a security guard, the security guard of the bank is not allowed to access the finances, right? So they have these two kind of restrictions should be there, correct? So do tarah ki restrictions yahan par honi chahiye. So we have to maintain both of these restrictions as a security issue. Okay, so from this you can see what are the drawbacks. Kya kya drawbacks hain? If I'm just using a file system of your operating system, then first drawback is data redundancy. That sometimes you are going to have duplicate data. The same data is stored in one location, the same data is also stored in some other location. Okay, jaise let us assume this is your file system. Ye aapka file system hai. So in this file system, this is a folder for HR department and this is a folder maybe for finance department. Okay, so here in the HR department we have one employee and the name of this employee is Himanshu. So all the information regarding this employee is stored in this data, जैसे what is the age, what is the family information, what is the name, what is the address and what is the salary, because HR department should know what is the salary of a person. एक person की salary कितनी है वो एक HR department को पता होना चाहिए. Okay? So HR department should know what is the salary of a person. At the same time, this finance department should also know what is the salary of a person. So they have to, so that they can credit that salary after the end of the month. मंथ के एंड में वो उस सैलरी को क्रेडिट कर सके. दैट इज वाई द फाइनेंस डिपार्टमेंट शुड ऑल्सो हैव द सैलरी इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ पर्सन. बट द प्रॉब्लम हियर इज द सेम इन्फॉर्मेशन इज स्टोर्ड हियर एज वेल एज द सेम इन्फॉर्मेशन इज ऑल्सो स्टोर्ड हियर. सो वी आर स्टोरिंग सेम इन्फॉर्मेशन इन टू डिफरेंट लोकेशन विच इज ब्रिंगिंग रिडंडेंसी इन द डेटाबेस, जो कि डेटाबेस में रिडंडेंसी को लेकर आ रहा है. ओके, सो वट हैपन्स इज लेट अस अज्यूम द एचआर डिपार्टमेंट गिव्स अ प्रमोशन. HR department gives a promotion to the guy and HR department says that I'm going to give you 30% hike in the salary. I'm going to give you 30% hike in the salary. HR department is giving that hike. But if that hike is not updated here, then the finance department will only transfer the old salary. Correct? So kya hoga dono case mein? So we should not have redundancy because of this redundancy, we can produce an inconsistent state. Because यहाँ पर जो सैलरी है, maybe the salary mentioned here is 1,30,000 and the salary mentioned here is only 1,00,000. So then people will be confused that which is the correct salary. लोग confused हो जाएंगे दोनों में से कौन सी सैलरी जो है वो करेक्ट है. Is this person having a salary of 1,30,000 or is this person having a salary of 1,00,000 only? Why? Because in both the places we are maintaining the same data in both the places and in both the places we are having two different informations. राइट, सो इसी वजह से यहाँ पर हमारे पास एक इनकंसिस्टेंट स्टेट आ जाती है. सो वी शुड योर फाइल सिस्टम इज हैविंग अ ड्रॉबैक दैट हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डेटा रिडंडेंसी इज देयर एंड सेकेंडली इनकंसिस्टेंसी इज देयर. सेकेंडली द सेकेंड ड्रॉबैक इज डिफिकल्टी ऑफ एक्सेसिंग द डेटा. डेटा को एक्सेस करने में डिफिकल्टी है. जैसे आई वॉन्ट टू से कि आपके पास कुछ हाउसेज का डेटा है. Okay, so this is maybe a city, you can say this is Delhi city, and this is information regarding all the houses in the Delhi city. Now I want to say that please tell me how many houses are there who are having two bedrooms, or you can say how many houses are two BHK apartments. Then what I have to do, so in this entire database I have to write program, I have to access all the houses, and then I have to check how many of these houses are having 2 BHK. Or if I want to say, let us suppose in all these houses how many percent of the people are having a motorbike, and in all of those people who are having a motorbike, how many of them bought this motorbike between the year 2007 to 2017. Yahan par aise kitne log hai जिन्होंने 2007 से लेकर 2017 के बीच में मोटरबाइक खरीदी है. एंड इवन आई कैन कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, आई कैन से हाउ मेनी ऑफ दीज मोटरबाइक्स आर ऑफ रेड कलर, हाउ मेनी ऑफ दीज मोटरबाइक्स आर मोर देन 50,000 रुपीज, हाउ मेनी ऑफ दीज मोटरबाइक्स आर हैविंग दिस मच ऑफ एवरेज. सो आई कैन कॉम्प्लिकेट दीज क्वेरीज. सो इफ आई एम गोइंग टू कॉम्प्लिकेट दीज क्वेरीज इन द रिजल्ट, द प्रोग्राम दैट यू आर गोइंग टू राइट हियर टू एक्सेस दिस डेटा दैट गोइंग टू बिकम वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. ओके, then we have multiple files and multiple formats. So maybe one person is using the notepad as a format .txt, another person using word file as a format. So because the different people you are comfortable with the different kind of file formats, so they can use different kind of file formats to store similar kind of data. So again they can have multiple files for the same data, as well as all of these files might be having different formats. Then we have integrity problems. देखो integrity problems क्या है. Sometimes I can say, okay, let me show it in this manner. So there are various kind of integrity problems. We can have referential integrity and all of these things. उसको हम बाद में discuss करेंगे. Let me give a very, very simple example. Okay. Let us assume I'm maintaining the database for a school. And here for a school, we have a student. Right? So obviously the age of a student in a school will be between 3 years to 20 years, correct? But what if somebody enters an age, let us suppose 200 years by mistake, राइट. सो दिस 200 इयर्स ऑफ एज ऑफ अ पर्सन शुड नॉट बी अलाउड, बिकॉज नोबडी इन द वर्ल्ड, कोई ऐसा नहीं है जो 200 साल तक जिया है. नोबडी एवर लिव्ड फॉर 200 इयर्स. But just by a single mistake, the person who was entering the data, instead of writing 20, he have written 200. So what will happen because of this? Your data will become inconsistent. Right? So you should maintain this kind of integrity. You should maintain that this is the values which are allowed. These are the values which are not allowed. कौन कौन सी ऐसी values हैं जो यहाँ पर allowed है और कौन कौन सी ऐसी values हैं जो यहाँ पर allowed नहीं है. So you have to maintain some integrity. Second, atomicity of updates. Atomicity of update means that only one person should be allowed to work on the database at a time. Ek se zyada log database par kaam na kar sake. After this, so because drawbacks is that if people are, you know, concurrently accessing the database, then they can create inconsistent result. And we also already have security problems. The person who is not allowed to access a certain database, then he is allowing, right? Well, if the same database is shared with the entire company and some person who is not allowed to access this database, so some portion of the database, then entire database is also shared with him. So obviously that is going to create a problem. मेरे कहने का मतलब है कि एक ही डेटाबेस पूरे कंपनी में सबके साथ शेयर्ड है और जो पर्सन है किसी को हमें एक पर्टिकुलर डिपार्टमेंट की एक्सेस नहीं देनी, बट वी कैनॉट डू इट. So obviously we have a security concerns here. So that is why we wanted to design a new kind of software to resolve all of these issues. And that new kind of software is your database management system, or you can say DBMS. So jo naya kind ka software hai jo ki is issue ko resolve karega, usko hum bolte hain DBMS or database management system. So in this DBMS is basically the database plus some set of programs or tools which can work on this database. And to work on this database, we have designed something called as structured query language, or you can say SQL. हमारे पास काम करने के लिए एक structured query language है जिसको हम SQL भी बोलते हैं. ठीक है, is it clear so far? इतना clear है आप सभी के साथ? Fine. So what is the benefit? What is the benefit? First of all, it will be very efficient to access because you do not have to write different programs to get different kind of data. We can just write a simple SQL query which will say select all the people who are having age between this and this and who are also having a motorbike. So I can just simply write a SQL query and I can simply get the data using this SQL query. Secondly, reduced application development time. So if you're going to write a program or if you're writing an application, so by using a database, it will be very easier for you to get the data which is required. So jo aapka time hai, which is the application time, development time, that development time will also be reduced. ठीक है, जो आपका जो development time है वो भी reduce हो जाएगा. Okay? And then you have integrity and security, obviously, because different people are having different accesses. Some people are allowed, some people are not allowed. So we can give them different accesses. I can say that I can define the rules that he's a database administrator. He can access these files. He can access everything. He's from a finance department. He can only access these databases. This is informations, right? And I can show that these kind of person are having this much access. These kind of persons are only having only this much access. So I can define different accesses and I can also define security for the database. Second, uniform data administration, right? And then we have concurrent access and recovery from crashes. So concurrent access, we have mechanisms to allow the concurrent access, ki kitne log concurrently access kar sakte hain, aur agar concurrently access kar rahe hain to usme se, just hold on a second. Yeah. So we have mechanisms to allow the concurrent access. तो उसमें हम लोग ये देख सकते हैं कितने लोग इस समय पर डेटाबेस को कॉन्करेंटली एक्सेस कर रहे हैं और इट शुड नॉट ब्रिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ कंसिस्टेंसी. ये कोई भी कंसिस्टेंसी इसकी वजह से नहीं होनी चाहिए. ठीक है, वी शुड नॉट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ कंसिस्टेंसी बिकॉज ऑफ दिस. सो ड्यूरिंग आई थिंक आई वॉज डिस्ट्रैक्टेड, लेट मी रिपीट माई सेंटेंस अगेन. आई एम ट्राइंग टू से we can allow people to have concurrent access, but even by after giving the concurrent access, it will not bring any inconsistencies in the database. So database mein koi bhi inconsistencies yahan par nahi aayegi. okay? And then we have recovery from crashes. So if there's any crash happening, so maybe there's a failure in electricity or something, some failure is there, okay? So because of that failure, we can roll back to the previous consistent state. So hum pichli consistent state pe roll back kar sakte hain, okay? So nothing happened. I think I was getting a phone call and a message. A lot of things are there. So I have to switch off my phone. That is why I got distracted somehow. So I was saying something, thinking something, something like this happened. Happens all the time. So I think you know, guys know, ki main bolna kuch aur chahta hoon aur ho kuch aur jata hai. Okay? Happens. Chalo. Let us try to see. So next one is, what are the characteristics? So humare paas characteristics kya kya hain? So one of the characteristics is using these databases, we can represent the real world entities. Jaise we have a student, right? So student is a real world entity. So all the information regarding the student, jo student ki information hai, we can represent an entity. We can represent the information of a student using a relation. Relation yani ki ek table. तो हम एक स्टूडेंट की जो इंफॉर्मेशन है वो हम यहाँ से शो कर सकते हैं. ओके, आई मीन वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट यूजिंग एंटिटीज, ऑल द रियल वर्ल्ड एंटिटीज, राइट? जैसे जो रियल वर्ल्ड एंटिटीज हैं उसको हम यहाँ से शो अप कर सकते हैं. सेकेंडली, सो रिलेशन बेस्ड टेबल्स, तो वी कैन मेक टेबल्स रिगार्डिंग द थिंग्स विच आर इंटररिलेटेड टू ईच अदर. जैसे स्टूडेंट है, स्टूडेंट इज रिलेटेड टू अ स्कूल, स्टूडेंट इज रिलेटेड टू अ क्लास. सो वी कैन हैव डिफरेंट टेबल्स हियर. And we can create different tables which are related to each other. Third, because of this database management system, we are going to have less redundancy. Redundancy yani ki duplicacy nahi hogi data ki. Then you have consistency. So aapka jo database hai wo consistent state par rahega. Consistent state means they will not be having any wrong information or misleading information. And after this, you can also have a query language. This is structured query language so that you can perform operations on the database. ठीक है, सो फ्यू मोर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर देयर. सो वी हैव मल्टी यूजर एनवायरनमेंट, मल्टीपल व्यूज एंड सिक्योरिटी एंड ऑल ऑफ दिस थिंग्स. एंड देयर सम एडवांटेजेस आई थिंक वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड. या आई नो थ्योरी इज बोरिंग, सो बट अगेन आई थॉट वी कैन कवर सम थ्योरी. सो हियर दिस इज अ थ्री टीयर आर्किटेक्चर. सो इन दिस थ्री टीयर आर्किटेक्चर, एज यू कैन सी, वी हैव कॉन्सेप्चुअल लेवल, वी हैव फिजिकल लेवल. So this conceptual level is also called as conceptual schema. Physical level is also called as internal schema. And then we have external level, or you can say external schema. So when I say this conceptual level ka matlab kya hai? Ki in what way you have organized the data. Jaise aapke paas ER diagrams hota hai. In case of a ER diagram, what are the entities and how these entities are interrelated to each other, right? So this entire ER diagram is your conceptual level. And then how the data is actually stored in the database in the binary format, that is your physical level. And how, what views your, what kind of view you can give to a user, that is your external schema. Jaise if we have a person from finance department, so he's only allowed to access a few of those tables. He's only allowed to access a few views. So we can have a different view for that. If a person is from laboratory, we can have a different view for him. If a person is from administrative department, so we can have a different view for him, right? So har ek department ke person ke liye hamare paas alag alag views ho sakte hain. That is called as your external view. So this is called as your three tier schema. So as it is completely theory, so I'm just skipping it, because all of you guys also told me ki aap skip kar sakte hain. So I'll be very happy to skip the theory, because I told you that I'm not very good with the theory. I'll be very happy to cover numericals. I'll be very happy to cover the places where some numericals and logics are there. Theory is very boring all the time. Fine. Then we have data model. So data model is basically how the data is stored. Data kis tarike se stored hai, usko hum data model bolte hain. Dekho, jaise let me show you. In a programming language, you have something called as variables. Okay. So using these variables, you can create structures. Structures are user defined variables. Structure means how you are going to store the data. And then using from this structure, we have created something called as objects. And using these objects, we have created something called as a data model. So data model is basically how this large amount of data is interrelated to each other and how it is stored. So we have different kinds of data models here. The first one is hierarchical database model. Second is relational database model, network model, object-oriented database model, entity relationship model, ER model you can say, document model, entity attribute value model, star schema, and object relational model. So you have, yeah, exactly. So you guys are also feeling my pain, I understand. So we have these kind of data models, right? तो यहाँ पर कुछ डेटा मॉडल्स हैं जो इंपॉर्टेंट है, जैसे यू हैव हायरार्किकल डेटा मॉडल, रिलेशनल डेटा मॉडल, नेटवर्क डेटा मॉडल, ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड डेटा मॉडल, यू कैन स्टडी दिस ईआर डेटा मॉडल, राइट? एंड आई थिंक सम ऑफ दिस मॉडल्स यू कैन स्किप, जैसे स्टार स्कीमा यू कैन स्किप, डॉक्यूमेंट मॉडल यू कैन स्किप, बट दे हैव आस्क्ड अ फ्यू क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस डेटा मॉडल्स. ठीक है, सो इन केस ऑफ अ रिलेशनल डेटा मॉडल आई थिंक, तो जो आपके रिलेशनल डेटा मॉडल है, हियर वी स्टोर द डेटा on the basis of relations, how they are interrelated to each other, वो किस तरीके से एक दूसरे से interrelated है. So here this is the information of a student and this is the information of their healthcare provider and how which student bought which healthcare plan. So this is how it is related. So we can store the data on the basis of relations, क्यों data एक दूसरे से कैसे related है. Then we have hierarchical database model. So this hierarchical database model, it was used in the year 1960s to 1970s by IBM. So it is more like tree like a structure. Ye tree like a structure as you can see here, and here each record has a single parent or root. And basically this, for example, here just like this is a parent and this parent is having some data which is this is a root. So again it is having some child and again it is having some child. So basically we are storing the data in this format. ठीक है, फाइन. आदित्य स्टिल देयर, आई थॉट यू आर नॉट देयर. ओके, सी आई थिंक वी कैन स्किप दिस पार्ट. तो ऑल ऑफ यू टोल्ड मी टू स्किप, ऑब्वियसली आई विल बी हैप्पी टू स्किप. आप सभी ने मुझे बोला है स्किप करने के लिए. ठीक है, सो आई ऑल्सो हेट थ्योरी पोर्शन बिकॉज थ्योरी पोर्शन इज नीड्स अ गुड प्रेजेंटर एंड मोर ऑफ वर थ्योरी पोर्शन समथिंग दैट यू कैन ऑल्सो रीड बाई योर सेल्फ, राइट? So I'll be very happy to skip the theory portion here. I'll send you the presentations and PPT and we will start from your ER model in the next class, or you can say your normalization. Yeah, I understand your pain. So mujhe aapka pain pata hai. I'll just do one thing. I'll send you this PPT again. So NoFly, in some of these introduction concept, yes, they ask a few questions. कुछ ऐसे theoretical questions है जो यहाँ से वो पूछते हैं. So you can also, you know, study this. I think you can also do it by yourself. Hardly 2 or 3 PPTs are left. दो या तीन PPTs left है, rest you can do by yourself. ठीक है, and then let us do one thing. From the next class, we can start with ER model. Directly let us start with the concepts rather than theory, because theory portion is very boring. सभी को पता है theory जो है वो बोरिंग है. सो आई कैन जस्ट स्किप दिस थ्योरी पोर्शन. ऑल ऑफ यू टोल्ड मी टू स्किप, तो आई एम गोइंग टू स्किप इट. ठीक है, सो लेट, ओके, सो सम ऑफ यू हु आर फीलिंग लाइक हाउ यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दिस, जस्ट डू गो थ्रू विद द क्लासेस, बिकॉज इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो इटसेल्फ हम लोग यहाँ पर ईआर मॉडल के बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे. वंस यू आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस ईआर मॉडल, जो ये सब चीजें हैं, ये सभी चीजें आपके साथ क्लियर हो जाएंगी. ठीक है, so I will take the next class in approximately half an hour to 45 minutes. Next class jo hai half an hour se 45 minutes mein hogi, then we can start with the good part. So this is something that I also hate. Theek hai, so let us meet in half an hour, I guess.